Hey everyone, it's Jane. I hope you're doing great. I grabbed the Birch Press Mandala stamp and stencil set out of my stash the other day and thought I would make a couple of cards using the same products and show you how you can get completely different looks. I did some white heat embossing with some ink blending with Catherine Pooler inks with my life-changing brushes, which really are life-changing, and added a bunch of little things, jewels. I also used the stencil on the envelopes just to give it a little more cohesive look, and what a fun envelope to receive in the mail. These are the majority of the products I use. The life-changing brushes, I use the Catherine Pooler Tutti Frutti, the Flirty Fuchsia, and a few other colors which I'll list below. This is the Shining Mandala stamp and stencil. And these, of course, are the life-changing brushes. And I did use Brutus Monroe embossing ink and alabaster embossing powder, which is my favorite. I cut all of my card bases to 6x6. I'm putting them in my Misti with a little bit of temporary tape. I use that temporary tape all the time to hold things in my Misti. I will then lay my stamp on top of it just to get a rough idea of where it goes. Lay it down and get a really good coating of the embossing bag so that my embossing powder does not stick. I will then get a really good coating of the embossing ink, close the top of the Misti, and then I use my microfiber cloth to push down on it. If I had a sleeve in the wintertime, I would have used my long sleeve, but it's summer, which I love. So I'm pulling that out of the Misti, and I'm going to grab my coffee filter and my embossing powder, and I probably should have used a piece of paper because you will see I make a big old mess. But I just cleaned it all up and off we went. So I'm laying that on there, getting a really good coating, giving it a little tap to get rid of the excess. I take a good look at it. Also, you can get a dry paintbrush and brush off any of the excess that's in areas that you don't want it to be. I heat up my Wagner heat tool before I went to work on this, and I will let you know that it does take a little bit of time. I did heat the back to eliminate some of the warping. And then I'm going to put the mandala stencil on top. There's four of them. I only used three today. I'm trying to figure out which one I want to put down first. I decided with this one, which they don't have any numbers or letters or anything, so it's really hard to say. But I am starting with the Tierra Catherine Pooler inks. I love these Catherine Pooler inks. I wish I would have gotten them in the larger sizes. But I do have the minis and I absolutely adore them. So I'm just giving a really good coating of Tierra on that first bit of stencil, Then I'm laying the second stencil down and using some Lime Ricky. I'm trying not to get even. I want a little bit of highlights. I want some darks and some lights just for a little bit more interest. Don't you wish you could just make things that fast? Sorry about my head. And look how cool that is. And what you really can't see right now is the white heat embossing that's on there, but you'll be able to see that later. I'm adding my third layer of stencil with the Orange Twist Catherine Pooler ink. And I'm putting the third layer on here. And it's just fascinating to see how all these different layers make such a difference in the card. I just get so excited when I work on stuff like this. I'm just such a card nerd. Anyhow, here's how it all turned out. I think it's absolutely fabulous. You can see some of the white heat embossing there as well. I went ahead and stamped in white heat embossed another 6x6 card base with white heat embossing, and it will show up here as I'm using this ink blending. I am starting out with the Lime Ricky, and I'm working my way around, I can't even talk, in a rainbow order. I'm not being really careful on my ink blending. I really wanted some differentiation between the colors. I'm swapping out my life-changing brushes and cleaning them in between the different colors. I have three that I work through. I think I need to get another set so I can have six just for the ink blending. You can see I'm putting the color down and then I'm going back and I'm adding more color to give it a little deeper color and to do a little bit more blending. And so as you can see at the end, it won't be as splotchy as it's looking right now. I'm not really concerned about the edges of the card base because I will be trimming all that off. Then I took my shimmer spritz, and it's the sparkle, and about 12 inches high. I sprayed it about 3 or 4 times to give it some really good sparkle. And then I took my microfiber cloth, which you do not see, and I wiped it all off to dry it. And can you see the shimmer in there? It's really hard to see, but in real life, it's really, really beautiful. I'm so happy I did that. I have all of my cardstock on rings with labels, and when I'm not sure what color to use, I grab it and pull it out. And I use the Blue Lagoon by Gina Kay and the Lawn Fawn Cilantro for the base of these sugar script dies. These are the Birch Press Big Thanks and Big Hugs. They are some of my most well-loved and well-used dies. I just love the way it looks. I'm using my liquid glue and gluing my white cardstock on top of the shadow part. And I then put an acrylic block on top of them so that they can dry flat and I don't have to worry about. I'm going to grab the stamp set and I'm going to white heat emboss the sentiments on some scrap of black cardstock. I will lay the sentiments out on my Tim Holtz glass media mat, which I absolutely adore. Pick them up with an acrylic block. And then I will grab a piece of black scrap cardstock. It's from a pouch that I made over Christmas. I think it's a little bear. And made sure I got it hit really well with that embossing bag. Use my Brutus Monroe embossing powder. And then I'm going to white heat emboss it. I use my Tim Holtz guillotine trimmer to trim all of my sentiments. I love the way it cuts. I can get a nice even cut when I lie it down. I'm taking them and I'm going to cut a fishtail on the end of each of this one. I did not feel like getting out my dies, so I use my scissors. You just cut down the center and then you cut your angles off on the sides. You will see later on though that I will trim those off and make the whole thing a little bit smaller. As I'm creating, sometimes I'm just really not sure how it's going to look. I have a thought in my mind, and then when I lay it all out, it doesn't necessarily all work out the way I thought. I'm using my 3M tape, cutting it in half. This is my favorite way of getting dimension. I put a little bit of bat on the back of every single one of my die cuts. I use my T-square to lay out to make sure my hugs was really straight. And then as you can see, I cut that sending down so it was a lot smaller. Sorry about my head. I'm laying out my thanks here. Again, I'll get my T-square out to make sure it's straight, and then I cut down the For Your Kindness to make it just a little bit smaller. My favorite thing's orange zest cardstock for the base, and put my card together. You'll see a better picture of it later. Sorry that's so fast. Here I am trying to figure out the base for this one. I grabbed the Gina Kay Sweet Corn, put the white cardstock in between the card front and the base, and I'm using my favorite stamp runner. It's a really good Tombow stamp runner. I'm putting the white on top of the base, opening it up the bottom to make sure I have the bottom facing down. If you ever made a card and it's completely upside down, I send them those crazy ones to my family. I then take some craft foam and use my liquid glue and lay my three layers out. And then I put my acrylic block on top of that so that it dries nice and flat. I'll do the exact same thing to the other card with the foam and the layers and the liquid glue, and you will have two completely different looks. And again, making sure which is the bottom, putting the acrylic block on, letting it all dry. So then because I could, I took a piece of copy paper and put it underneath my 6x6 envelope. And my cards all finish out at 5.5x5.5. I put the stencil on top and I taped it. And then I'm using the Lime Ricky. And I'm covering the flap of the stencil. I just think it's really fun when the envelope matches the card inside. Sometimes I just do sentiments, and sometimes I just use washi tape. So that's how that one came out, and then I'm going to do the exact same thing for the blue card. And there is a picture of the card with their matching envelopes. Because there's repeating patterns with a mandala, I'm going to put some Pretty Pink Posh clear droplets down and some Little Things Cantaloupe Jewel Mix on this first card here. And I'm just laying down my glue in all the areas, and I am putting some of the jewels on my table with my, picking it up with my Crystal Catania, which I love. I do have the magical bead tray, the triangle there, and I love that because when they're upside down, you give it a little shake and they all become right side up. So I put the clear around the edges and the bridal mix, the cantaloupe mix in the middle. I'm then taking my Nouveau Crystal Glaze and covering the hugs. I wanted to give that a little more shine, and it gives it just a little bit more dimension. And square cards do cost more to mail, but look how pretty that is. I think it's worth it in the end. Look, you can see the white heat embossing there and all the different layers from that stencil. I am then going to take the Little Things Bridal Mix, and I'm going to layer in a circle. I'm not layering at all. I'm laying in a circle different sizes. I'm going to use the medium and the tiny ones, putting one, of course, in the center. And then I'm going to grab the real tiny ones and put those around the edges. You'll see in just a second, right there, you can see in that center layer. And oh, I can never get my cards in the middle of, just that purple tape there, that's to show the center of my work surface. Oh, one of these days, guys, one of these days. Anyhow, here are my two finished cards. I hope you all like them, and I hope it's something that you might want to go out and make yourself. Enjoy. Have a wonderful, wonderful week.